गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ दिस इज योर वीडियो फॉर बैलेंस डाइट एंड डिफरेंट फूड ग्रुप्स। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल लर्न अबाउट द डेफिशिएंसी डिजीज आल्सो एंड ओवर निरिशमेंट। ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द बैलेंस डाइट। व्हाट इज बैलेंस डाइट एक्चुअली? इट इज अ डाइट विच कंटेन्स राइट प्रपोर्शन ऑफ ऑल द न्यूट्रिएंट्स। ऑल द न्यूट्रिएंट्स मीन्स कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स, फैट्स, प्रोटीन्स, विटामिन्स एंड मिनरल्स। ऑल दीज न्यूट्रिएंट्स should be in the right proportion and all these nutrients are necessary for growth and maintaining good health. So whatever we are eating, our diet should contain all the nutrients in right proportions. Okay, then that diet is known as balanced diet. Okay, now you can take the food items from to make a balanced diet from the food groups. So what are these food groups? These food groups is of four types. First one is protein group. In the protein group, you can take the food items rich in proteins and fats. From the protein food group, you can take the food items which are rich in proteins and fats. Okay. Next, milk group. From this group, you can take the food rich in proteins, fats, minerals, and carbs. Carbs over here are carbohydrates. Okay, from the vegetable and fruit group, you can take the food rich in carbohydrates, vitamins and minerals. Okay, this food group mainly includes vegetables and fruits. Last one is the fourth group, that is cereal group. This cereal group contains those food items which are rich in carbohydrates only. They include rice, chapati, bread, noodles, etc. Because all these food items are rich in carbohydrates. Now, you can see that our meals should have enough amount of carbohydrates and fats because they are energy giving food, and protein should also be there because they help us to grow and build muscles. And also help us to heal quickly. Heal quickly means whatever injuries will be there in our body, they will get healed, they will get repaired quickly. Then our meal should have proper amount of vitamins and minerals because they act as the protective food and help our body in fighting against the disease. And then water and roughage for good digestion. Now, you know that different people have different diet based on the different factors. So a diet that should be a balanced one, it depends on the following factors. That is the age, gender and type of work. Age means like a growing child means a teenager needs more amount of protein as comparison to the adult one because they are at the growing stage. Okay, or we can say a growing child needs all the food, means all the nutrients in a proper amount so that it can grow properly. Okay, then gender means like males need more energy giving food because they do lot of energy consumptions work and as comparison to females of the same age, because in the earlier times females were just living at the home and doing the household chores. So but now females are also doing the same type of work which a man do, so they accordingly at some respect gender also plays a very important role in the type of diet a particular person can have. Then type of work means that farmers or the laborers need more amount of carbohydrates and fats as comparison to the person who are living a sedentary lifestyle that we have discussed in the last video also. Okay, and athlete will have a different food requirements than a school teacher. Okay, so likewise this type of work also relates to the type of balanced diet a particular person can have. Okay, now next is how to retain nutritional values. Nutritional values of food, whatever nutritional values present in the food, how we can get all the nutritional values. Okay, so first is we should always wash the fruits and vegetables before cutting or peeling them, because if we will wash them after cutting or peeling, then all the nutrients, vitamins and minerals will get soluble in the water. And there are certain vitamins which are soluble in water, that is vitamin B and vitamin C. Next is, we should always peel the we should try not to peel the fruits and vegetables if possible, because most of the nutrients are present in their covers, in their peels, in their skins. Okay. Next, excessive washing of any cereal like rice or pulses, then all the vitamins, most of the vitamins and minerals which are present in them, they get removed. Okay. Next is, we should always include some fresh fruits and raw vegetables which are rich in vitamin C as salad in our diet. Okay. And always keep in mind that heating destroys vitamin C. Okay. Which vitamin get destroyed by heating? Vitamin C. So we should always take care that the food items rich in vitamin C should not be overheat. Okay. Then overcooking should also be avoided, because whenever we overcook the food item, all the nutrients present in them, they will get burnt or we lose all the nutrients. Next, minimum water should be used when boiling some food items like potatoes, because if we will use excess water in boiling, then we will just drain out that water and the nutrients present in that water will also be lost. So we should always use less amount of water in boiling and others. Okay. Now our next topic is deficiency disease. Now deficiency disease. So deficiency means किसी चीज की कमी हो जाना. Okay. So the disease which occurs when a diet lacks necessary nutrients. Okay. In your diet, if there will be the lack of some necessary nutrients, then disease will be occurred, and that disease are known as deficiency disease. Deficiency disease leads to malnutrition. What is malnutrition? It is known as poor health. Okay, malnutrition means poor health. You will not be healthy if there will be deficiency of any necessary nutrients in your body. Okay, malnutrition, that poor health can occur because of, if you are intaking the food that is deficient in nutrients, like there will be less nutrients in your food, or you are taking excess food, bahut zyada kha rahe, because when we were discussing about the nutrients, then I told you about the results of overeating and undereating. Agar aap bahut kam kha rahe ho, then also you will suffer from the disease, and if you are taking a good amount of food, excess amount of food, then also you will be suffered from disease. Okay. So this malnutrition has a flow chart. It is of two types. Either it is caused due to undernourishment or it is caused due to overnourishment. Undernourishment, there will be the deficiencies of the nutrients, and overnourishment, the means excessive food intake is there in this. So first of all, we will read about the undernourishment. Undernourishment can be caused because of four reasons. First, there should be the deficiency of carbohydrates, or there may be the deficiency of proteins in your body, or protein energy malnutrition. Here, protein energy malnutrition means there will be the deficiency of proteins, carbohydrates and fats, because they are come under the energy giving food. Malnutrition means poor health. There will be the deficiency of these three. Okay, or the deficiency of vitamins and minerals. So undernourishment means it is the condition in which the deficiency or poor absorption or excessive loss of nutrients from the body. Okay, loss ho raha hai. Okay, so first of all, we will read about the deficiency of carbohydrates. You know that carbohydrates supply energy to your body. So when you there will be the deficiency of carbohydrates, then your body will not get proper amount of energy. Okay, and this will lead to the weakness and loss of stamina in your body. Next is deficiency of proteins. You know that proteins are bodybuilding food items. Okay. And if there will be the deficiency of proteins, then kwashiorkor will be there. Kwashiorkor is a deficiency disease caused. Kwashiorkor. is a deficiency disease caused due to the deficiency of proteins. And what happens in it? It affects the physical and mental growth of a child. Next is protein energy malnutrition. In short, we can call it as PEM. We can call it as PEM. Okay. Now, in this, both kwashiorkor and marasmus. Kwashiorkor and marasmus will happen. Marasmus is caused due to protein and carbohydrate and fat deficiency. Protein, carbohydrate and fat deficiency will cause marasmus. And what happens in this marasmus, the growth of a child will stop completely. Okay, growth nahi hoga iske andar, theek hai. And kwashiorkor mein physical or mental health develop nahi hoti bachcho ki. Fine. Now next is deficiency of vitamins and minerals. You know, vitamins and minerals are known as protective foods. So if there will be the deficiency of vitamins and minerals, then what will happen? It will lead to disease. Okay, means the body will not protect itself or fight against the disease. Now the next one, there is a table. Diseases are there, that vitamin A causes night blindness, B1 causes beriberi, B12 causes anemia. About that we have already discussed when we are learning about the nutrients. Okay. Now the last one is overnourishment. Overnourishment is the condition of in which consumption of excess nutrients, excess means more amount of nutrients of one or more kind, will lead to the condition of overnourishment. ठीक है, जब अपन बहुत ज्यादा किसी न्यूट्रिएंट को कंज्यूम करते हैं, खाते हैं, ठीक है, देन फैट आर एनर्जी फूड. फैट्स जो है वो अपन को एनर्जी देते हैं, बट इफ यू विल ईट मोर अमाउंट ऑफ फैट प्रोडक्ट्स, fat rich food, then it will get stored in our body, in our tissues, and cause imbalance. That we all already have discussed, that if there will be excess amount of fat in your body, then there will be the obesity condition and your blood will not flow properly, and it will lead to a disease that is known as obesity. Okay, accumulation of excess fat will get in the body and due to overeating, and it is called as obesity. Obesity harms the body in various ways. How? It increases the number of heart disease that we have discussed, then back pain, etc. Therefore, we should always take care that we should eat right amount of food items. Okay, we should not eat lot of amount of sweets and fried foods. Increasing the level of physical activity, like you can means play outdoor games, sports, yoga, exercise can help you burn the fat and you can be able to live a healthy life. Okay, so this is all about our chapter 2, that is components of food.